Welcome to this first video on WebPart Basics in SharePoint 2013. WebParts are containers that draw content from lists and libraries and display that content on web pages. WebParts can also add functionality to a web page, such as creating a set of tabs for an efficient user interface. There are many WebParts available within SharePoint, and they vary widely in purpose and configuration. So this video serves as a general introduction to adding, editing, and moving web parts. In this video, we'll use the Image Viewer web part as an example. First, let's add the web part to a page. Open the page for editing by clicking the Settings gear and Edit Page. Then, click OK to check out the page. We want to place an image at the top of the page, so click the Add a Web Part link in the header zone. In the Web Part gallery, click the Media and Content category, then the Image Viewer Web Part. The header zone appears in the Add Part To dropdown as the Web Part destination. Click Add to insert the Web Part. Here's the Web Part in the header, so let's save the page. When you add a web part to a page, you are adding a copy of the web part. The original web part remains in the web part gallery. You can insert several copies of the same web part on the same page, and you can insert different web parts on the same page. Here's another way to add a web part. This time, open the page for editing by clicking the Page tab and Edit. The page is automatically checked out. Click the Insert tab and Web Part. Choose the Media and Content category again, then the Image Viewer Web Part. This time we didn't select the zone for the web part, so click Header from the Add Part To dropdown. Click Add to add a second Image Viewer Web Part to the page. Since we don't need that, I'm going to cancel. Now that the web part is on the page, we need to tell it what image to display. First, let's make sure the image is in the Images library and get its web address. Go to the Settings gear and Site Contents. You're prompted to save changes. Although we haven't made any changes since our last save, go ahead and click OK. On the Site Content page, scroll to and click the Images library. Hover over the SharePoint image, click the ellipsis, and copy the URL. Let's go back to the page and open it for editing. Click Page and Edit. Open the web part for editing. Hover over the title of the web part, click the down arrow, and click Edit Web Part. The tool pane appears in the right part of the screen. You may need to scroll right and up to see it. Options in the tool pane let you customize the web part. Paste the image's URL into the image link text box so the web part knows where to find the image. Click Test Link to make sure the address is correct. Add SharePoint Overview as alternative text. In some browsers, alternative text appears when the user hovers over the image. It's also useful for the visually impaired. The alignment and color options don't need to be changed. Expand the Appearance section and change the title to Example of Image Viewer. Change the Chrome type to Title and Border, then click OK. Here's the image in the web part. This is the title of the web part, and this is the border around the web part. Let's save and check in the page so others can see the new image. Click the Page tab and Save. Then, use the link in the yellow bar to check in the page. In the comments, note that we added a SharePoint image, and click Continue. Let's review more of the appearance options, since they apply to most web parts. I've already opened the page for editing. Edit the Image Viewer web part, and expand the Appearance section. You can define a height and width for the web part, but it's usually best to let the web part adjust automatically to fit the web part zone. A Chrome state of Normal displays content as we've already seen with our image. A minimized Chrome state hides the content of the web part. Let's apply the change, and you'll see that the image is hidden. Go back to the tool pane and look at the Appearance section again. Chrome type controls whether the title and border of the web part are displayed. Earlier, we used title and border for the Image Viewer web part. The other options let you show only the title, show only the border, or hide both title and border. Default generally shows the title and border, but this may vary by web part. Let's change to border only so the title will not appear, and OK the change. When you save the page, the web part is completely hidden because the Chrome state is minimized and the Chrome type doesn't include a title. Let's edit the page in web part and restore the Chrome state to normal and Chrome type to title and border so the web part is ready for our next example. If you need to rearrange web parts on a page, you can drag and drop the web part, or you can use the layout options. Let's drag the Daily Reports web part so it is above the image. Hover over the title and pause until the pointer changes to a four-way arrow. Hold the mouse button down and drag the web part to its new location. If you have trouble getting drag and drop to work, use the layout options in the tool pane. The zone option moves the web part from one zone to another. Open the Image Viewer web part and, in the tool pane, expand the Layout section. Our web part is currently in the header. Select Top Left from the Zone drop-down and click OK. The web part is immediately moved from the header to the top left. To rearrange web parts within a zone, use the Zone Index. Web parts with lower index numbers appear above web parts with higher numbers. If we want to move all announcements above daily reports, we need to know the zone index number for daily reports. So open the Daily Reports web part and expand the Layout section to see that its index number is 1. Now edit the All Announcements web part and change its index value to a number less than 1, such as 0. Click OK, and the web parts switch places. In this video, we've examined how to add, edit, and move web parts. There are companion videos that describe how to hide, delete, and close web parts, as well as use specific web parts, so take a look at them once you're comfortable with this material. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.